This sentence is very complicated for me to understand. I read and read again and again, and finally realized what would it say. Okay, I read that again. That, something that, which is already has been. And that already has been is also, is to be. So it was in the past. It has been carried to our past, our present right now. And this is also already has been too. So it is like keep occurring. What would that be? Probably that would be something nature in us or in here. Today, I'm going to talk about something reoccurring again and again in our lives. And this is interesting. I mean the last part of the verses, today's scripture. And God seeks. What is God is seeking? God seeks what? I mean, those things. What has been driven away? Or, I mean, in Hebrew words, I mean, in original text, and KJV, it has been said, what had been pursued. Something is keep coming, keep following you. And it has been carried with you all the time. And that is which God is seeking for. That is today's verse. And there might be something that you can think of, but today I want to share shortly about my past. I want to start with something positive. I have a past that I am still proud of. I have something proud of. I like that. I still like that. But still, those things actually sometimes give me strength. But something in the past that is not I'm proud of yet. I have scars. I have a trauma that hinders me, that really brings me to down, deepest place of down, down deep someplace. Everyone would have a scar. Everyone would have something like inabilities that would just come again, occur again, again. And they feel like it does not go away. I would like to say about this. You would say, Pastor, there are so many things to talk, but why do you say the scar or something past rather than just, I mean, good thing? I want to start with this. If you are a true evangelist, if you are truly a person of God, then this is something happens. I want to remind you of this. If you are truly a person of God who are saved, then you have adversary. That is, you have to keep reminded in your lives. Otherwise, you will be deceived a lot. Your life is different from the life you are living with your friends. Your friends cannot find this type of life in your lives at all, in their lives at all. But if you are true children of God, if you are really an evangelist who were thinking of gospel and thinking of, I mean, delivering gospel to friends, then you have certain adversary that is very, very powerful and stronger than you, which is Satan, devil. And what this devil does is keep throwing past, I mean, especially negative, sinful, or elusive to you, so that you can keep falling into your past, keep falling into scars, keep falling into inabilities you feel like you cannot escape from. That is something I want to remind you again and again. And I want to share my life too. Think about the something if you have. Before you were coming to the worship, last week, what did happen to you? What is something that reoccurs again and again? You might have that one. I'm a fortune teller, but still, I know that if you are children of God, if you are a family summit, that surely will occur. That really happened to you. I'm pretty sure because Satan did to me too. It brings you again, again, so that you feel like, oh, that place, that happened again. And I don't want to confront anymore, and I want to avoid, but it's inevitable. It's coming to you, right? That is what Satan does. I talked with a member of our church last week, and we talked about our past. We talked about our future. We talked about the life of evangelist. And she said that, Pastor, there is something coming to in my mind that had not happened to recent years. That was the thought and memory of my time, my past. That was very shameful. And when that memory occurs, it reminds of my reaction to go back to my old nature. You know what she's saying? I mean, our sinful nature. She wants to go back to sinful nature. Certain kind of the feeling like keep away from that and hide it to there. Certain feeling arises. And at the same time, feeling shameful. There was a time that I could not meet God. I really suffered. So I don't want to think about that. That was very shameful too. That actually passed me suddenly. And she wondered, why did it happen? Pastor, why did it happen to me? Is it something like I coming back to that nature? Is it the reason why, I mean, I'm not being guided by God properly? She was saying, asking to me. And I said to her, that is what Satan does. That is what devil does. Don't be alarmed. Don't be surprised that your past sometimes just pass by and they feel like, oh, there is a certain acquaintance I know of this. I didn't have this, I mean, past year, past month, but suddenly that coming again. And I don't want to see, why did it happen? I don't want to see that. I saw some people who came to our church and said that, Pastor, I didn't have certain feeling of my sickness of my body, my feeling. But when I come to the church, this happened again. Pastor, is this church is a really good church? She asked me, right? That occurs. You know what? Because you have an adversary. It is adversary. Otherwise, you cannot actually think of others. For sure, I want to just make sure that we have old nature. We have scars. Even though we are saved by Jesus Christ, our Lord, He is mighty and He's stronger. He's strongest, a person who can lead you, who can save you, and who can empower you too. But still, The one who is saved, is still sometimes weakness in the parts of our lives. We have weakness. Pastor Park has a weakness. Our educated pastors have a weakness. Our team leader has a weakness. Our praise team have a weakness. Everyone has a weakness. But God doesn't want to see the strongest part and save us. Or neither He saved us because we are weak. No. I mean, God has certain feeling, sympathy, feeling of pity. So He loved me and He saved me. That's in part that's true. But no, I would say no. God does not care whether you are weak, whether you are strong, whether you are smart, whether you are really, full. He doesn't care. He just loved you. He just picked you out of millions. Everyone is sinners. Everyone is the person who are unable to certain place, certain time. He just loved you. Whether you are strong or not, whether you're smart or a fool, whether you made a decision really good or not, He just chose you. And He gave all His heart, mind from the heaven to you. And our situation is in sin. Our situation in our, certain urgencies, certain problems. So He also gave us the power of salvation. That is foundation of His love. That is foundation of His love. So we have to praise Him. We have to come to Him just like we praised, before our sermons, because He is who He is. We come to Him because, we praise Him because we know who He is, who you are. That is the reason why. So, coming back to my point, we are actually chosen by God. God has loved you and He is bringing you us. But this Satan, because he knows that we are sinful in certain part, we have weakness, we have unbelief. So he keeps throwing something that we can catch by. Do you have a dog in your house? Do you have other pets in your house? Every animal has certain indulgence, if I can say. One time, a cat should stay for 2 weeks in our house, and all our family members have to focus on how to handle this beloved animal. It is really hard to carry. One thing I realized is this animal, this cat, he liked something, the object that is moving quickly. You know, we have, snatching things. It tried to fetch. Well, whenever it moves fast, it is carrying. It is actually looking for that. That is his instinct, right? You know, dog also has certain indulgence too. We have certain indulgence in us. When certain things come, certain motion comes, certain feeling comes, we feel like we cannot keep ourselves from seeing that. When it comes, we cannot avoid to just react. When it comes, we cannot escape ourselves from, getting hit and fighting against with our own will, right? We have our own indulgence, our nature, and Satan knows, devil knows. And you know what? For non-believers, Satan do this in order to perish one's life. So Satan can use it once for one's life. But if you are a child of God, then Satan knows that he cannot perish you. So he throws our past, our something to give indulgence every day. Or, I mean, more than frequently, he throws that at us a lot. So that's the reason why we have troubles more than friends that we are looking around. We have conflict more than people, non-believers, experience. Because Satan knows that, I mean, he has to hinder you from receiving answer, hinder you to be joyful in the gospel, in joyful in the love of Christ. So Satan does that, keeps throwing at you. Okay, then what is scars that actually makes you hinder and makes you to coming back to your past? I heard and I have lived with feeling of separation from the people I love. I really loved to be loved by my parents. I loved to be loved by friends. And I really look for the love in our lives. And I'm so grateful. I'm still loving, I'm still living in, I mean, kind of a loving congregation and a loving family. But sometimes I have a certain feeling that I'm afraid to be abandoned, or I'm afraid to be separated from, forsaken by the one whom you loved. That is my fear, because that happened to me in my lives. When I was elementary school, I mean, still remember, you know, this is a very trivial thing. I mean, for some, right? But for me, this is really huge. My friends, they all turned away from me. For 6 months, I couldn't talk to anyone, any one of my friends, because they decided not to talk to me. And I kept to, I went to school with loneliness. I went to the church with loneliness. I had to play by myself. There is no one near us. And you know what? Interesting was, there is a friend came by, and even that time, I didn't know the problem I had. The thing is, I have a really thorny tongue at that time. My tongue was very, very sharp, you know, to the, you know, tear people away. I didn't know that. I played swing in the playground. A friend of mine has approached, but when he saw me, he was like, he couldn't approach to me. So I said to him, why don't you play with me? Why friends are not coming to me? And he said, I was not allowed to play with you. That was at that time he said to me, you know, very childish, please understand. And I couldn't understand at that time. And I asked him, why do you not want to play with me? And why they do not want to play with me? And he said simply to me that, because you are mean. You know, children, you know, children's words, you know, I have very, very, I mean, spiky, thorny tongues at the time. I was so mean at the time. And I had to work on my tongues. I have to work on with my relationship from that time. I have such a scar. Having in heavy relationships, sometimes even in my life of here at this time, sometimes I have such a fear too. And you know what? Satan, he knows it. He throws at me every challenge that he could have, that if I keep away from, from the person by my words, by my decision, then I'll be afraid. That is his weapon. He does that. There is a fear. And you know what? This is not something that I want to tell, but I have to make short. Because of that, what does happen is I come back to my fundamental problem of sin. I seek myself rather than God. You know, at that time, I am broken, right? I feel broken when I fear the separation, when I feel, the people leaving me, then I feel broken, right? Sometimes I do that too. I do experience that one too. Then I'm broken. Then, you should have come to God, right? I should have come to God. But I can't. Instantly, I come back to the mode of protection of myself. I do make excuse a lot because he did that, because she did that, because he did not do that. I am so busy to protecting myself. I try to heal myself. So I try to find some kind of the healing indulgence. That is myself. And Satan knows that. And that is fundamental problem. Separation from God. Interestingly, we human beings, even though we are children of God, when we have certain moment of scar comes, we do not come back to God. Interestingly, we keep away from God and looking for some place to hide, some place to save myself. That is separation from God. That is, you know, fundamental thing. That is exactly the trap Satan does. He keeps throwing at me and pushing me to the corner where there is no God. Today, you will hear in second service, you will hear sermon from Pastor, the Reverend John Schumacher. He will talk about the story of Jacob and people's, keep away from God for a long time and the confrontation to God. You will hear and you will receive a lot of grace from that sermon too. And that is the same, actually, theme here. People try to keep away. And that fundamental problem is a real problem. Scar is not a problem. Something like, I feel lonely, it is not a problem. That can happen because even though I'm saved, God is protecting me, but my brain, my amygdala, that part is still keep bringing me back. And Satan brings to me. That's not problem. Problem is because of that, I run to the place where there is no God. There is no answer. There is no prayer. I just keep away from there. That is Satan's focus. And when we do that, God is even chasing there too. Do you recall the verses that we read, Ecclesiastes chapter 3:15? Can you Can we see? Can you look at it again? Okay. So, what Satan does, what Satan brings up, which was already has been, and which is to be, already had been, those things, and the last part, God seeks what has been driven away. God seeks those things, and he wants to save that one. He wants to destroy that one. I like that part is exactly the verses that we have recited over and over again. 1 John chapter 3, 8. The reason why the Son of God appeared is to destroy the works of devil, destroy the sin, destroy the separation from God, destroy this Satan's work. That is what God is seeking. That is what God is seeking. Isn't it amazing? Your scar, your past, you can have it. I'm not saying that, but please keep having it. That's not what I mean. That can happen. The thing is, because of that, Satan is pushing you to the corner, separation from God. And Satan tried to be master over your lives. And it is like a snare. Keep pushing you to there. That's the reason why God is seeking what has been driven away. He wants to be master. He wants to be savior of that place. He wants to be with you, even that place. That is what we praise him. So if you have a broken part, welcome to the worship. If you feel loneliness, welcome to the worship. This is the part. This is the time. This time of grace, not only that, but also this is time to you really give out what God has seeking for. Show what God has seeking for. Say to God, Lord, this is what you have looked for. And I am here, I am. Lord, please be my master. Please be the one who destroyed this sin, this problem of Satan, this problem of my sinful nature, this problem of my failure. Receive it and be our Savior. That is our worship. That is our life. From there, the power of salvation occurs. The power of resurrection occurs. And the real answer to prayer occurs. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for giving us a wonderful time to realize that what you want, seek. Lord, what we can give to you is still that negative ones. But we are so glad that you want to see that. Lord, thank you so much for your wonderful grace and your wonderful mercy for us. And Lord, we want to enjoy true power of resurrection throughout all this experience. Lord, please with us from time and from all the situation we have. Lord, thank you. In Jesus' name, we pray. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of Father, and the work of the Holy Spirit be upon all who receive true salvation and true healing and the true seeking God by revealing their heart from now and forever.